Some video games just shouldn't exist. There, I said it. We can look at some games and just think, how did anyone give this one the green light? Not because the game is, by any means, bad, but simply because it's so outlandish and ludicrous that it's hard to believe that any publisher would take a gamble on releasing it. Either due to their bizarre niche premise, the seemingly aimless nature of the gameplay, or the cost-prohibitive peripherals needed to actually play the game, these titles should have all flopped. But instead, they are a celebration of originality, even if they ended up being run into the ground by franchise fever. My name is Rach, and welcome back to What Culture Gaming. These are 11 ridiculous video game ideas that should never have worked. Number 11, Guitar Hero. Guitar Hero is a musician simulator in which players have to fork out cash for a glorified plastic Fisher-Price controller on top of the actual game itself in order to pretend to play various classic rock tunes. It was a fanciful project, and one that should have lost Activision millions of dollars, right? Instead, it made Activision billions of dollars between the years of 2005 and 2010, before the series died a death from oversaturation. Still, for those 5 years, it was one of the most talked about pop culture products, featuring in a wealth of TV shows and movies. It was a must-have item and inspired the also brilliant Rock Band, which followed a similar trajectory of huge popularity followed by a meteoric downfall. Guitar Hero parties at university were hands down the best parties ever. Number 10, Lego Movie Games. A video game series based on Lego is a pretty genius idea. But a video game series that combines Lego and famous movie franchises, it's an ambitious and novel concept. But does it really have the mileage to become more than just a cheap cutesy gimmick? Just look at the number of LEGO movie titles that have been released. Harry Potter, Star Wars, Indiana Jones, Batman, Pirates of the Caribbean, Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, and even the LEGO movie games. The main reason that these games work so well is the huge sense of fun and adventure that they create, largely thanks to surprisingly intelligent scripts and excellent voiceover work. Not to mention the satisfaction of collecting every single little Lego stud as you beat up some orcs in Middle-earth. Number 9, World of Warcraft. The MMO genre had been around for years, but it truly took off when Blizzard's World of Warcraft arrived on the scene at the end of 2004, quickly becoming the most subscribed MMO of all time. Still, should it have worked as well as it has? Firstly, there's the fact that the game is rooted more in addiction than any finessed gameplay mechanics, and I can confirm that one. Mindless repetition often takes priority over varied gameplay and a great story, at least before the expansions. Then there's the fact that the game has a monthly subscription fee, and though many MMOs prior to it had required monthly payments, they never reached anywhere close to the all-time high subscriber count of 12 million that WoW had in 2010. Though WoW only boasts 5 million players now, it's a far bigger success than anyone could have anticipated. Number 8, Paperboy. Why would kids spend their paper round money on a game about paper rounds? Surely this would never catch on. A video game based on the grossly underpaid job that most people had as a kid? Despite having virtually no storyline and dated visuals for its period, the ridiculousness of Paperboy is what makes it work. The game is literally just a 7-day trip through the life of a paperboy, avoiding obstacles in the road and aiming papers at porches and mailboxes. If you smash the windows of your subscribers, then they will cancel their subscriptions, and if you lose them all, then it's game over. Conversely, you can gain bonus points by screwing with non-subscribers, smashing their windows and tipping over their garbage cans. So take note, everybody, please make sure you subscribe. This anarchic spirit perhaps contributed to its success, but it's proof of how mainstream a very weird premise can become. Number 7, Worms. Worms. Worms armed to the teeth with an array of delightfully demented weaponry. It's an idea so daft it could easily have been forgotten as a meek attempt to latch onto the same audience who fell for lemmings several years before. But its cutting sense of humor and its hugely entertaining combat quickly made it a popular franchise that continues to thrive to this day. What really makes these games work is the hilariously diverse arsenal, from the holy hand grenade to the banana bomb, the sheep, and my own personal favorite, the old woman. Worm warfare is as much fun to play as it is to say. Worm Warfare. Number 6. The Sims. If TV shows like Big Brother and video games like The Sims have revealed one surprising fact about humanity, it's that we really like watching people live their regular lives. The Sims is the highest selling PC game of all time, despite the core gameplay being pretty simplistic. But that's precisely why it's so popular, even with non-gamers, because it doesn't have an end point. Though the attention-seeking behavior of the characters can prove annoying when they constantly need to be reminded to flush the toilet after they've had a shit, the fun is in moving to a bigger home, starting a family, and all of the drama that accompanies it. Number 5. Katamari Damacy. Katamari Damacy is easily the weirdest game on this list, and so its modest level of success is a miracle in of itself. The protagonist is the Prince of All Cosmos, who uses a ball called a katamari to collect objects, from pencils to people to buildings, that will create new stars and essentially save the universe, as you do. Like so many brilliant games though, it's all about the simplicity. If Katamari Damacy had a dozen rules that players had to follow, it would never catch on. But this is a game pretty much about collecting tat. The humor might not be to all tastes, but the reason this game became a cult classic is because of its unique premise and addictive gameplay. Number 4. Mario. A short, fat Italian plumber's quest to rescue the beautiful Princess Peach from the tyrannical, grotesque creature Bowser. That's pretty much the premise for all the entire Mario series, and it's nothing short of amazing how well the character has endured over 3 decades, despite not really doing all that much to change things up. Sure, the graphics get nicer and the level designs are changed, but the core idea has been fairly similar since the start. Yet perhaps it is that very familiarity that has made the game a hit with both hardcore gamers and casuals too. It is difficult to imagine executives having massive confidence in Mario back in his Jumpman days, but he defied the odds and won the hearts of gamers the world over. Number 3. Pikmin. Believe it or not, despite the child-friendly exterior, Pikmin is actually a pretty challenging game, which requires players to use the titular creatures to reassemble their spaceship. Only certain coloured Pikmin can perform certain activities, so there's a high degree of strategy to it, and micromanaging all the Pikmin at once is not something that young kids will have an easy time with. As such, Pikmin is a game that looks like it's for kids, but is in fact geared more towards adults who are still young at heart. Pretty niche audience to fill, but the series has sold roughly 3.5 million copies to date, and has an extremely passionate fanbase. As a more simplistic game, it would have easily been appealing to children, but Nintendo had something a little more daring in mind, and somehow it worked. Number 2. Minecraft. Much like The Sims, Minecraft is an immensely popular game, seemingly because of its virtue that there isn't an endpoint or even a specific goal, simply that players have fun and immerse themselves in the world. The concept revolves around breaking down and placing building blocks to create structures. Much of the game's unexpected success, given that it has rudimentary graphics for one, comes from the creativity that it allows, resulting in a multitude of unique creations as well as some that draw from the world of pop culture. What helped take Minecraft to the next level is its ubiquity across platforms, including not just PC, but consoles and even mobile phones. This game is literally everywhere and combines both the casual and the complex in a totally ingenious manner. Number 1. The Nintendo Wii. Perhaps most surprising in gaming history was Nintendo's Wii. Pre-release snickering suggested that the console would probably enjoy modest success at best, given the mockery of its curiously urine-related name badge and the riskiness of the motion control gimmick. But it ended up decisively beating the PS3 and the Xbox 360 in the 7th generation, selling more than 100 million consoles and helping bring gaming closer to the mainstream. On paper, it seemed like an idea destined for failure, to sit alongside the Sega CD and other misguided peripherals as an outlandish gimmick that wouldn't connect with audiences. But oh, how wrong we were! The Wii defied the odds and managed to succeed with non-gamers, casual gamers, and Nintendo's hardcores all at once, and it was simply mind-blowing. Wii Sports needs ported to the Switch. That's all I'm gonna say. Get it done. And that's our list. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching. Hope you're having a great day. You look beautiful today. Just wanted to say that. Once again, my name has been Rach. You can follow me on Twitter if you like, at @DontRachQuit. Subscribe to see more lists like this every single day, and we will see you tomorrow.